With us on Island Focus today is Kaiulani Odom with the Kōkua Kalihi Valley Organization. Thank you for joining us, and you're an organization, association, community.
We're actually a federally qualified health center, and we started almost 46 years ago. We had one trailer, a doctor, a dentist, and I think maybe four outreach workers, and they went out into the community every day to make sure the community knew about the services they had to offer, but also to find out what the community needed. And what they found out was that the community needed a health center, so our ED got his church to sell part of their land in order to build our health center. And in fact, not many people know, but the very first Crater Festival was a fundraiser to fund the building of our first clinic.
We talked about this earlier. I think we were both there.
I was there.
In the late 70s.
And I often ask people in the room who was there, and there's not many that raise their hands nowadays. Yeah.
So Kōkua Kalihi Valley is a place. It's a center. Mm-hmm. You also have spoken very specifically about how health affects families and communities.
Right, so we're our community health center, and we had one site. We now have nine sites that encompass a 100-acre nature park where we do organic gardening and cooking and forestry and bring people up to get on the land. We have sewing programs. We have K-Vibe, our bike program. We have our wellness center. We have our clinic. We do everything from dental to behavioral health to WIC to medical.
You're so fortunate and blessed here in Kalihi mm-hmm. Valley to have the space and also the community, mm-hmm. a multicultural community everywhere in Hawaii. But some of the urban areas that couldn't create something like this, what might you suggest that they could do?
Well, you know, when people think about Kalihi, some of the very first thoughts are, you know, first and third largest public housing, high crime rate, lower socioeconomic rate. But in the midst of all this, what we choose to focus on are the resilience of our families, the culture of our families. What are the similarities that we all have together? And that's how we build community. You know, my program specifically deals with food, and how does food help make us healthier? And it's not just about blood glucose or losing weight. It's that our food connects us to our land, it connects us to our ancestors, it connects us to our culture, it connects us to our spirit, connects us to our next door neighbor. And when we aren't connected to these things anymore, where we don't care about our land, when we don't care about sharing stories or sharing food, our spirits are broken, our communities are broken. And so we look to the growing of food, the preparing of food, sharing of food. How do we bring a community together over food? And we have a lot of programs that do that. In fact, one of our mission statements talks about neighbors being neighborly to each other. And that's the truth. We try and create a space where everyone, all different ethnicities, all different, you know, from types can come and they can feel welcome, they can feel safe, so then they can work on their health from the inside out.
I remember growing up in Kaimuki when the auntie next door made extra cake, you know, mm-hmm. or extra spaghetti, and my parents were working, she would bring it over to us. This is sort of what you're talking about, sharing.
Sharing, yes. And then not just the sharing of food, but the sharing of knowledge and the sharing of stories that whether you're Micronesian or Samoan or Hawaiian or Filipino, when you see a kalo plant, you know in your culture that you had some of these different plants, whether they be food plants or medicinal plants, and you can sit down and you can talk about how they were shared, how they were grown, what are the stories from your background, from your culture, and in doing that, we can build bridges, we can build bonds with each other over our commonalities.
So are you planning another concert soon?
that would be a way to bring people together. Fundraiser. Yeah, we do have a fundraiser, especially for ʻŌlelo, and we are, you know, we are an organization that is a federally qualified health clinic, but because we offer so many unique programs, we also run on 60 to 70 grants a year, and mm-hmm. so we are always looking for ways to fund our innovative programs.
Well, mahalo for taking the time to share with us the importance of food and family and connections and relationships.
Thank you.
We've been conversing with Kaiulani Odom with Kōkua Kalihi Valley. Thank you for joining us.